7, and we're home, and something funny's happening. Let's watch. Ryan, what's wrong with mommy?
He's hiccuping.
Ryan, let me tell. I know Jake knows. Ryan, what's wrong with mommy?
Making that noise.
Mommy, can you stop making that noise?
I can't stop, unfortunately.
Everyone want to say bye?
Once was a group of trees who were fed up with living in a deep, dark, and crowded valley. So they decided to move to the top of a nearby hill. Here they could enjoy the sun on their leaves, fresh air through their branches, and the best view for miles around. But trees cannot walk without magic, and the creatures that followed them created an enchanted forest. Outside, darker creatures wanted the magic for themselves. This is the story of how a little boy came into the forest but left the way open. It was a crisp and frosty morning. Woodwind and Waffle were out collecting snow beetles when they found a boy. A real boy asleep in the snow. They hopped around in circles, saying,
What to do?
Shadows came bobbing and gliding toward them from every direction. Unicorns and woodhoppers, weasels appeared. Owls and magpies and skitlings dropped from the bending branches. Funny-looking creatures peered around each other, and even the trees shuffled forward. Cowslip, a tall and gentle creature with hairy knees, spoke first.
What shall we do with him?
The unicorn stepped forward and said, But Woodwind and Waffle were hopping again, saying, he was quick to understand magic, and he was very good with snail glue. But his skin was snow white and always ice cold. Whatever he touched for more than a few moments turned to frost. Now, in a dank valley with its curling mist, there lived many thick, stubby creatures with green, oily skin. Goblins, they smelled of boiled cabbage and liked to make rude noises just for fun. Clever they were not. And when they heard that Jack Frost, a real boy, had been shown the magic of the enchanted forest, they were furious. Goblins believed that magic should be theirs. Now the forest was open. This was their chance. That night, Jack Frost was playing with a friendly pack of Bing Bong Bandits. These were large animals, but they scared easily. Indeed, at the first sign of danger, they would roll onto their back and pretend to be asleep. So when a goblin came stumbling across Jack Frost with a bunch of snoring creatures, stuffed them into a sack, and scurried off back to the goblin lair. King Gobbledygook plucked Jack from the sack. He was surrounded by cabbage-smelling goblins. Jack said,
Hello.
And touched the royal nose. The king squealed. Together, the goblins snickered. Jack said,
That's easy.
If I show you how to catch the sun, you must promise never to go into the enchanted forest with Jack.
But if I tell you how to get the magic, how to catch the sun, then you must promise to never go into the enchanted forest.
So the goblin said, Jack knew they were lying, but he had an idea. So that night, the goblins followed Jack to the lake. They were very excited. Jack said, into the lake. With wide eyes, the goblin saw a thin film of frost creep and crackle and glistened across the lake. The moment it had turned to ice. Well, the goblins were delighted, and they lifted the frozen sun and ran off. They didn't even say thank you. But by the time they had reached the stone tower, the ice had melted and the sun had gone, and they were all had wet hands. The King Gobbledygook growled and said,
We've been tricked.
With screams of rage, they raced back to Jack. Goblins could only stare with stiff grins and chattering teeth. Woodwind and Waffle rushed to meet Jack. And they said,
No goblins.
The unicorn said,
let's celebrate at once.
Who could see how brave Jack had been? Everyone cheered with delight. All night there was music, magic, and a warm juice surprise. Jack was so happy, he tingled all over. He could feel himself getting lighter and lighter. Then he was flying. Jack never did remember his past, but at last he knew where he belonged. And the goblins? Well, they're still looking for their magic, and they're still grumpy, but that's goblins for you. Sometimes on cold winter nights, you may see swirling shapes of ice on your windows or frosty puddles in your garden. Yes, Jack Frost likes to visit places outside the Enchanted Forest, and he always leaves little spells of magic to protect you from the smell of boiled cabbage. The end.
Play the music on the alien. Okay, let's see your dance. Where did we get that toy, by the way, guys?
McDonald's.
Oh, what, do you guys like eating at McDonald's?
Yes! Yes!
Okay.
I especially only love one of them because they have a playground. I love two of them because one of them has a playground inside and one of them has one outside.
Really? I didn't know that.
All right. Yes, you!
Alright, bye guys!
Bye!
Bye, Molly!
Well, Ryan, wait.
Down the monkey.
Well, Ryan is going to be three in a couple of months. And he has some jokes to tell us.
Are you going to tell the chicken jokes?
So tell us the jokes, Ryan.
Why did the chicken cross the road jokes?
Because he wanted to eat a giant.
He wanted to eat a giant?
Yes.
Tell us some more jokes.
He wanted to eat a cheek.
Maybe all done.
He wanted to eat a nose. He wanted to eat a head. He wanted to eat some food. He wanted to eat a giraffe. He wanted to eat a cup. He wanted to eat a watch. He wanted to eat a picture. He wanted to eat a butt.
What's the question, Ryan? What's the riddle?
He wanted to eat a microwave. He wanted to eat a microphone.
No.
He wanted to eat a cello. He wanted to eat a violin.
Jake, what's the question?
And it's a top.
What is the question? Why did the cake cross the road?
And then he wanted to eat a pizza cake.
What's the question?
An animal.
What's the question?
What's the question?
And then he ate an eyeball. And
then what's the why did the chicken cross the road? What's the why?
And then he ate a forehead. And then he ate a leg. And then he ate a foot. And then he ate a toe. And then he ate a jewel. And then he ate some cake. And then he ate a race car. And then he ate a cabinet. And then he ate a window. And then he ate a raccoon.
Well, good. I'm glad
he ate
the raccoon.
And then he ate a harmonica.
Okay. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.
Do you want to say bye, Ryan?
Bye.
Okay.
Wait.
What are you guys doing?
Yeah, baby. Do you have a new belly?
Why? I don't know.
What?
I don't know.
A lot or a little?
A lot.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
More than two.
And why is today a special day to look at babies in your belly?
Because Mita's going to have a baby.
Okay, you want to show her how you have babies? Ready?
Boing.
Those are all the babies.
Boing, boing, boing. Going.
How many babies do you guys have?
We have a lot.
We don't know how many. Okay, fine. I'll count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
Whoa, that's a lot of babies, guys.
Say good luck, Mita.
Good luck.
Good luck, Mita.
Thank you.
what he thought was...
Why? I was always five hard riding with five. What's he
doing?
But what she thought was...
Good job, guys!
What were you guys listening to?
We were listening to Cow Planet number one.
Okay.
I'm not done with that.
You're all done with it? Okay.
All right, bye, guys.
I'm not.
Okay, we're going to still videotape Jake. What's the next one, do you know?
Pots and Pans.
Pots and Pans,
pots
I don't remember
pans.
That one.
Pots and Pans?
I am.
Oh, excellent. That was the boring song.
Oh, I forgot.
Should we go to the next song? Should we go to the next song? Dance too?
That's some good dancing, Jake.
Okay, bye.
Bye, guys. Good dancing. Where are we?
At the beach.
Yep. And how old are you now?
5.
Yep. Can you show us some of the crabs you caught?
Daddy, I'm not going to touch any of those because that guy almost grabbed the bat, one of my fingers. I'm going to do one of
yep.
There.
All right. And how many hermit crabs do you think you got today? Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know
what Ryan, can you show some of the hermit crabs you got also?
I got that one. I got that crab.
Okay. You want to say bye?
Bye.
Bye. Yep.
We're at Skagit Beach in Orleans, Cape Cod. And we used to come here mid-1980s. And we had a house somewhere right back there. We could walk right to the beach.
Right. And one of the things about this beach is the tide, right?
I see all the hermit crabs. There's tons and tons of hermit crabs. And it's 2007.
It's Ryan
is 3.
It's birthday.
Darcy's birthday. It's Darcy's birthday. It's always 2007.
It's
a tickle.
Hey, it's September 11, 2007. The boys are actually going to go to sleep soon because they're getting ready for school tomorrow. And I just wanted to record this because they're being so cute. And Jake has been reading to Ryan in bed for about half an hour. So I just wanted to record that Here it is.
As the water-wise animals and people try to stay safe from moves, these people are trying to stop the water. They're making a wall of bags filled with sand. Not all the rain can seep into the ground, so it covers land. Huge waves can cause floods. They are made by storms or by undersea volcanoes or earthquakes. A flash flood is a sudden rush of water. It happens when a lot of rain falls in one place in a short time. Some floods happen when snow and ice melt. The soil is still frozen, so it cannot soak into it. What's gonna be a good one? This one. The sea. Okay. Headlands, cracks, caves, and blowholes. Arches, stacks, and stumps.
Anyway, that was really cute. They're doing so well. Bye-bye.